everyone, welcome to the last week of lab. This week we're going to be going down to the Muddy River. So one of the people in your group is going to stay here and make the chemicals, and one person is going to take this long stick with a cup at the end and this plastic bottle and fill it with Muddy River water.
Walk. Make sure to look both ways when crossing the street.
Okay, I'll go watch you.
Watch me. Don't go.
Okay, go. Wait. There's stuff
we have the right of way, so. Okay, so now that we're outside and by the Muddy River, we're gonna pull out our trusty map and we're gonna find where we wanna go on this map. So it's really important that when you take your sample, you wanna put like an X kinda near where you were on the river. Okay, here comes the gross part. So usually we would have one person holding this and one person scooping the water, so then one person can pour the water and like it wouldn't be as messy, but due to budget cuts, I'm just gonna do it myself. So, take one. Okay, so the most important part about this is that you don't wanna disturb any of the sediment around, so you don't wanna get, like you wanna try to get as little dirt as possible. This is gonna like help you filter, you know, you're not gonna have to filter out as much of the dirt with the Buchner funnel later, so. Just let it filter in. And then scoop the disgusting water out of the pond, river, and pour it in. Okay, and then once you're done, you're gonna pass it off to your colleagues and you're gonna be out here. Hopefully it's nice weather and we're gonna truck back. Let's go, gang. So now that you've collected your river water, we're going to filter it in the Buchner funnel, and you're gonna wanna make sure that the filtrate that comes out is as clear as possible.
Salt bridge. See, it's right there. I'm going to take it apart. And that's going to be it. So, that's one part. Now, we've got to get the pieces that we're going to use to make our cell, our electrode. We need to do the titration. So, there's a lead with black that's going to go into a multimeter. It's copper on one end, and the other is the silver electrode, and it's going to go into the other end of the multimeter, and it has a silvery end to it. The other pieces are you need, this is going to be the body of the electrode. This is going to be a septum, it's going to hold the fluid in. And this is, string is going to make our salt bridge. And that's going to be it. So the first thing is we've got to snuggle this on, and it's a tight fit. So I'm going to wet this end here. And kind of turning it around, twisting it around, I'm going to... Sure it's nice and snug, not too snug, not too bad, because anyway I've got to put in the salt bridge, so we don't need very much coming out. So I guess that's all we need, a little bit at the bottom like that. And then snug fit this on here. So I'm doing a twisting action like this, and it's a tight fit, which is what you want. Okay, there you go. There it is. Voila. So inside you can see we have some of the cotton, which will be conductive, and this is the going outside into the solution. Since the solution's that we're going to be testing, that is the chloride, is going to be up to here. We don't need all of this tailing on. So take a scissor and cut that off. So we just want to have a little bit slip on here. So there's our salt bridge. Some of the thread is inside, some of it is outside. And now we have to do the electrode. Inside is going to be the copper sulfate solution. So that's going to be our copper wire here. This is going to go on the outside, like this. That's going to stick into the solution. So here we have our septa cap. We have the salt bridge here. We have the copper wire inside, and we have the silver on the outside. And now what we've got to do is we've just got to kind of make that an item, either with tape or with a heat gun. And we have some shrinkable material. And so it's going to look, you know, something like this. This is what we're trying to do. Oop, turn it around this way. Okay, so there's the septum. Copper goes inside. Okay, the silver goes outside and contacts the solution outside, and we just need a way to shrink or wrap that on top, and that's our electrode that we're going to use.
Make sure that your electrode all stays together. We just put a piece of tape around the top just to hold it, but you can also use shrink wrap and then heat gun it to also make it stay. Once you have your electrode made to connect it to the multimeter, you're just going to put the black in the black, the red in the red, and then you can turn it on millivolts. And then you're going to want to make sure that you get an initial reading of your solution before you start titrating.
So now that you've prepared your 50 milligram per liter solution of chloride solution, what is it?
Chloride standard.
So now that you've prepared your chloride standard, you're going to pour 100 milliliters of it into a 250 milliliter beaker. And then you're going to turn the stir bar, or the stirring on. Make sure there's a stir bar in the flask. So next you're going to fill the burette with the 0.004 molar solution of the silver nitrate, and then we're going to titrate into the chloride solution. So before you place the electrode into the chloride solution, you want to fill it with the copper sulfate solution, and you want to fill it to about where the white tape starts. So we're going to fill it all the way up there. So that's pretty good. And now, to take the initial reading, you're going to the electrode and hold it in place with the three-pronged clamp. So lower it down into the solution and make sure that you have the stir bar in there and that the silver portion of this white wire is into the solution, that your salt bridge is connecting. So you can see right now that our salt bridge is not connecting. So we're gonna have to like take a pair of tweezers and stick it down there. But let's see. So you want this to be submerged so that the circuit connects. Okay, so this is good now. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna fill So this is the initial reading. It's reading the millivolts. And what we're gonna do is fill this up with the silver nitrate standard, and you're going to titrate the first 15 milliliters into here and get a reading, and then you're gonna titrate 1 milliliter each time after that, and then get your titration curve.
Yep, and you should be graphing as you go like we did in last lab. Your x-axis is the milliliters of the silver solution, and your Y is the millivolt reading that you get, and you just keep going. But as you get closer to where this jump is, you're gonna wanna decrease the amount of silver solution that you're adding. So you can do it by 0.2, or however small you can get it, by 0.1, and then you're gonna get this graph. And once you have that, then you can make your first derivative plot, which you're gonna graph is your silver nitrate added versus the change in millivolts over the change in milliliters. So you just make the graph just like we did last week, so that way you can capture this point.
want to switch.
No.
I don't know how to do this. Yeah, wear different shoes on this day. Yeah. Is this what vlogging is? You know?
Yeah.
I'm into it. If you're not weird, you're weird. Okay, this is a good... Okay.
Jump up in the air. Okay.